Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back with more Super Mario 64 DS. Last time, we took a break from Ba-Bomb Battlefield after not being able to do one of the missions as Mario, which led us to collecting three of the 30 Secret Castle Stars in the Princess's Secret Slide level, and that also took us into the Rec Room here, where we got introduced to the minigames and Sunshine Isles. And now that we've collected 8 stars, we can proceed through this door off in the corner right here. Head on through. And we have kind of this weird little room here. We've got this window that leads to a balcony you strangely cannot access, ever. Pretty cool little chair here, though, to perch ourselves on. But more importantly, we've got this painting of Mario right here. So let's jump inside it. And we are taken to this strange labyrinth titled Goomboss Battle. Yeah, that's seriously it. Goomboss Battle. Not the most inspired level name I've ever heard, but I ain't complaining. It's a pretty cool level here. There are actually multiple stars that we can collect in this place, but we won't be able to access. Oh wow, I didn't know Yoshi could eat coins. That's pretty cool. Yes, there are multiple stars that you can get in this place, but we won't be able to access them straight away, just because we don't have, you know, Yoshi doesn't have all the abilities necessary to get them. However, off to the right of the start here is this kind of tricky to get one up, and it's even trickier to get back, but it is possible to do with Yoshi. Possible to get it and get back, so. Yes, we've got all these Goombas running around here, running rampant here. We've got the poison gaseous fumes, the swampy fumes in the off the side of the platforms there. You don't want to fall in there, otherwise you'll take damage. You can climb up on the grate here with the B button. If you hold the jump button here, the B button, you can hold on and climb around. And let's spit this guy out. Now, I want to show you something here. See that black brick block all the way out there? Well, we can't do anything about that. That's one of the things that that's what I mean by, you know, Yoshi doesn't have all of the abilities necessary to complete everything. So what we want to do to proceed is, yeah, climb up this beanstalk here. And if you go to the very top, you'll grab another one up here. And if we go up the ramp, find the dickishly placed Goomba there. On up this way, find these guys here. And go down the hole here. Into the lair of Goomboss. Wahaha! I am no ordinary Goomba, I am Goomboss. The Great Goomba, the Grand Poobah Goomba. That Mario always stomps on us, but now the tables have turned, I locked him up in a room. Very descriptive there. I bet he's crying like a baby. I have no business with you, so scram! There's no way a prehistoric wimp like you could beat my stupendous stumps. Ugh, trying so hard not to burp during all that. Anyway, Goomboss here. He is going to circle around the poison pit here, the purple poison pit, and what we want to do is just run all the way around. This isn't the only way to do this, but it is probably the easiest way. Gobble up one of his Goombas, poop him out into an egg, and throw the egg at him. And so, he'll get extra mad here, and what we want to do, you can do this where you can... Yeah, you can jump behind him, you can flutter kick behind him, and get him with the element of surprise, yeah, and he'll grow even more. Oh, now he's mad. Oh boy, yep, he's pooping out all of his Goomba minions here. Oh no, throw that egg, there we go. I think that got him. Yeah!
Oh, beaten by a pipsqueak like you, how did that happen? Is it just the Goomba's fate to lose? I have Mario locked up in a room, you know. The key will open the door. This key will open the door to his room. I still can't believe you beat me.
And he becomes so full of hot air, he poofs into smaller Goombas. And with that, we have a key with an M and a red cap on it. Mario's cap. So grab it here, and oh yeah, watch the touch screen when you grab it here. I don't know why that makes me laugh. It just turns around in like a bunch of different angles. But anyway, yeah, we have defeated Goomboss, and we collect the Mario key, And you've probably already guessed by now what we will do with this key here. We'll throw it away. No, we aren't gonna throw it away. We're gonna open up Mario's door with it. So let's go. Put it in and...
Mario!
You've rescued Mario! Now he can smash Bowser in style. Red caps are everywhere. Grab one to turn into Mario. Thwart Bowser's sinister plans with super moves. Alright, and look at that! We have switched to Mario, the actual Mario.
Yippee!
I think that's such a great entrance there. But anyway, now that we have unlocked Mario, we can go back and do missions that we weren't able to do earlier as Yoshi.
Yeah!
Now, we could go back to Ba-Bomb Battlefield. However, there is still one other thing we need to do before we head back in order to proceed in that world at all. So we're actually going to go back into here, back into Throwback Galaxy, Womp's Fortress here. Right back on into the painting. And we have just mission number two. Yeah, we're still early on in this world, to the top of the fortress.
Let's-a-go.
Alright, so now that we're cruising here as Mario, as the name says, we need to get to the top of the fortress.
Yahoo!
So let's do it. Oh, how did I sail right over the... I don't know how that happened, but... Anyway, we'll just leave that at that there. I don't know how I sailed right over the piranha plant, but... You know. Evidently, that he just... I don't know, maybe the piranha plant was just good at dodging attacks or something. Even while he was sleeping.
Whoa!
Oh, something I want to show off here. Nothing really that important. But, don't go sailing off the edge there. That would be terrible. I want to go up here. Yeah, if you climb to the top of this flagpole here. Whoa, yeah, you can take a nice little shortcut on over to the pedestal here where we battled the Womp King. And I'm trying to get this to do its thing here. Come on now. There he goes, Bullet Bill! The only time Bullet Bill ever appears in the N64 version. He appears a few more times in the DS version here. But yeah, you gotta admire Bullet Bill. And you could get hit by him just because he only appears a few times, but hey man, I ain't got the health for all that. So let's just focus on getting to the top here. And we have a nice easy star, we don't have to fight any big bad uglies for it. We can just grab it, and we're out. Back into Womp's Fortress, we've got Mission 3, Shoot into the Wild Blue. So, here's another quick and easy mission. Womp's Fortress really does have some of the quickest missions in the game. And it's a good, you know, it's a pretty good, introductory level to more of the game's functions. Hi, I'll prepare a cannon for you. So, to do this, get this star, we have to talk to the Ba-Bomb buddy here. Ready for blast-off. Come on, hop into the cannon. So if we hop on in, as he says, we can make use of the cannon here. And what we want to do, I like to shoot right about here. And, ooh, Mario smacks his face right into the pillar there. But it's a good way to stop yourself from just go sailing right over. But we come down here, and I miss the star. Give me a second. I love how I say it's one of the easiest stars to get, and yet I just sail right past it. Oh my god. I swear. Only when recording. Alright, so our next mission is Red Coins on the Floating Isle. Now this level is gonna be... we're gonna do kind of a two-in-one here. If you talk to the Ba-Bomb Buddy straight away right here, we're peace-loving Ba-Bombs, the Ba-Bomb Buddies. We don't like explosions at all. We aren't blast-happy like the Black Ba-Bombs. We just can't help how we look. Some of us can sense where red coins are. See? Look at the map below. Isn't that something? Mm-hmm. When you're looking for stars with red coins in their names, our buddies will be waiting somewhere. Please talk to them. So yes, as you saw there, all the red coins to collect in this stage are shown on the map when you talk to the Ba-Bomb Buddy. I gotta tell you, man, having the DS like, playing on the DS and being able to use the map to find, like, red coins, silver stars, like, just regular power stars, it is just the most handy feature, man, I'm telling you what. But anyhow, I said that this was going to be a two-in-one, because remember the purple coin missions from Mario Galaxy? How you have to collect 100 of them to make a star appear? Well, that originated in this game. Instead of purple coins here, before it grew into the purple coin comets, what you had to do originally in Super Mario 64 was just collect 100 coins, 100 regular coins, in each stage to make a star appear. It was an extra star that you needed in order to get 100% in the game. But it's, you know, it's not the most obvious thing. It really, you know, you don't really know about it until you may have accidentally collected 100 coins on your first time playthrough. Regardless, though, yes, you have to collect 100 coins in every main world in order to make a star appear, putting the total number of stars in each world at 8, as opposed to 7 in the original N64 version. And, oh wow, this coin just went sailing right off there. Yeah, you had to collect coins, you had to collect 100 coins in the original Mario 64. And yes, some levels are definitely, it's definitely easier to do in some levels than others. So what I'm going to do, because we're already at 65, is I'm going to do just that. I am going to go around and collect the red coins in addition to other coins, just to get our 2-in-1 star here. Now, I'm trying to think where... Okay. I did miss this one, that's right. Gotta get back over to here. Yes. Yeah. Gold coins are worth 1, obviously. Red coins are worth 2 coins. And then the blue coins, as you will see later, they are worth 5 coins. So, I want to get back to the top of the fortress here. Because, no, Mario, do not slide. Get up there. Come on. Oh, come on! Why couldn't I hit him that time? Alright, screw that guy. Just gonna run on past him. Keep getting my coins here. Let's run across. And interestingly, in this level, some of the red coins, well, one of the red coins in particular, has been moved. This red coin, I believe, was not here in the original N64 version. It was in a different location. So... Oh, nice, I made a 1-up appear. Alright, now let's just get around here. Ah, oh, Womps have plenty of coins to offer. Yeah! Yeah, down on your face! Fucking smash! Let me smash. Anyway, around here. Yes. Boom! Okay. Up here. Do an old, nice old backflip up. Now. What has to happen is we need... Ah, yes, right over here. We need to do is... Oh, what the heck? Oh, Bullet Bill did get me. What we need to do is kick this... Oh, other way. Yes, kick this board over. And carefully go walking across. And the camera keeps rotating even though I don't want it to. On its own. Camera. Go. 6. Yeah. Right here. And right here, we've just collected our 100th coin, which makes a star appear. Now, collecting the 100 coin star, you've collected 100 coins. You gain more power from the castle. Do you want to save? No. Collecting 100 coin stars do not warp you out of the map. So you will just be able to continue on about your business here. I can't believe I'm about to ask the Ba-Bomb Buddy for help with the... Oh, wait a minute. I think I know where the last red coin is. I should know where the last red coin is. I only played this mission about 100 times. Maybe. Is it back here? Yes, there it is. I was about to say, if it's not, I need an adult! I don't know where the I don't know where my lunch money is! Oh, goodness. No, no. Give me that. There we go. All right. So, I'm just going to run back. Oh, goodness. I tell you what, there's nothing more painful than collecting 100 coins and all the red coins and then dying before you even get to either of the stars. That is just one of the most painful things. Anyhow, you've recovered 12 power stars. Now you can go to the door with the big star, but Bowser is just ahead. And is that the sound of the princess calling for help? All right, well, we can go do that. Actually, it'll be a while before we go do that. But I say we can do one more mission here before we sign things off for this episode here. So let's fall onto the Caged Island. This introduces another new concept, not to this particular version, but a new concept that you don't really see a whole lot else. Check this out. Climb up in the tree, we wake up this owl.
Who's there? Who woke me up? It's still daylight. I should be sleeping. Hey, as long as I'm awake, why not take a short flight with me? In standard mode, press B to hold on and release B to let go. I'll take you wherever you want to go as long as my wings hold out. Watch my shadow and grab on.
All right. So, this is pretty cool here. Jump up to the owl and just hold the B button.
Yay!
And we, yes, as the name says, we just take the owl on over here and fall onto the Caged Island and grab our star. It's that simple and a lot easier of a mission than in the N64 version. So, with that, at 13 stars, we're going to continue on. And next time on Super Mario 64 DS, what we are going to do is continue in Womp's Fortress and hopefully get back into Ba-Bomb Battlefield. Till then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.